New tonight, a first-of-its-kind food pantry is opening up in the city to bridge the gap within the Latino community. The group behind the movement says food insecurity shouldn't be an issue, no matter what language you speak. Roxanne Elias live in studio tonight to explain why it's so badly needed. Roxanne?
Melissa, it's called the 419 Food Pantry, and it's catering to Spanish speakers here in this area. That's because sometimes they have barriers when they visit a regular food pantry.
Uno, dos, tres.
In a Spanish countdown, Toledo's first Spanish-English 419 food pantry is opening its doors.
We got in the freezer, we have turkeys.
You can find it on Broadway in the Old South End.
We decided to come and check it out to help us with the flour. I do a lot of tortillas, so.
The idea comes from Linda Parra, the founder of Nuestra Gente Community Projects.
We started thinking about this project when we did the 7 large food distribution during the COVID-19 pandemic. We saw the need through our food large distributions in the parking lot.
Add the pandemic hardships to language barriers and immigration issues. Jesusa Moreno, a retired mother of 4, says Spanish speakers find it hard to visit a regular food pantry.
It's kind of hard for people that don't speak English, you know, and finding somebody that speaks Spanish, they feel more comfort talking Spanish.
Latinos don't have access to benefits because their immigration status. So food is a basic human right, and this food pantry will be open to them, and we will provide twice a week.
And with time, Parra plans to promote this as just a stepping stone for other bilingual food pantries.
This is only the beginning, so we are helping little by little, and then when you do little by little, it goes bigger and bigger, so that's our goal.
As things get more expensive, Moreno says this pantry will help her pay for other necessities.
Especially the gas. Gas is getting too expensive, you know. Like help with the light, something that we need to survive.
The 419 Food Pantry will be open on Tuesdays and Thursdays. And just to be clear, you don't have to be Latino to be helped there. You will be asked to give some information, but the nonprofit says its goal is to not turn away anyone. Reporting live in studio, Roxanne Elias, WTOL 11.